In this example, we will examine the motion of an object that is moving in a circular path and is subjected to multiple forces. A rod rotates clockwise about point O with a constant angular velocity of 3 radians per second. When the rod is horizontal, a small block of mass m is placed on the rod 18 inches away from point O. If the mass begins to slip toward point O at an angle theta equal to 50 degrees, what is the coefficient of static friction between the block and the rod, named mu s? For this problem, we will assume that the size of the block is much smaller than the radius of curvature of its path, allowing us to treat the block as a particle. First, we draw a free body diagram of the block and identify the coordinate system. Since the block moves in a circular path, normal and tangential coordinates are more convenient. The t-coordinate points in the direction tangent to the block's circular path, and the n-coordinate points inward toward point O. The friction force opposes the motion of the block and is oriented an angle theta from the horizontal. Since the block starts from rest, the magnitude of the friction force is the coefficient of static friction times the normal force n. The block's weight points downward and has the magnitude of m times g, the gravitational acceleration constant. And the normal force acting on the block is oriented an angle theta from the vertical and has the magnitude n. Next, we apply the equations of motion. The sum of the external forces in the n direction is equal to the block's mass times the acceleration in the n direction. The sum of the external forces in the t-direction is equal to the block's mass times the acceleration in the t-direction. The sum of the external forces in the n-direction is the n-component of the weight, which is mg times sine theta, minus the frictional force mu s times n. The normal acceleration is the angular velocity of the block squared, times the radius of curvature of the block's path, which is r. The sum of the external forces in the t-direction is the normal force n minus the t-component of the weight, which is mg times cosine theta. The acceleration in the t-direction is equal to the time rate of change of the block's speed, v dot. Since the rod is rotating at a constant speed, v dot is zero. We now have two equations and two unknowns. Solving for the coefficient of static friction and plugging in the values of the variables, we find that mu s is 0.54.